We are in a situation at the sheriff's office, quite frankly, that we do not want to be in. We are forced into really the first point of contact between convergence of property law, criminal law, and really constitutional issues. Now, at the end of the day, our responsibility is this: to balance the best interest of the public with private properties on the right, and to try and mediate the problem to the best of our ability to do so. We don't like where we're at, so let's be frank about that. I think I've also been very clear that the changing of positions over the last, give or take 120 days, is caused by, I think, is a tremendous amount of confusion. So we're now in the fourth official position in 120 days. My situation, or the situation of the deputies, is simply this: I don't get to decide what laws I enforce. That is a non-sequitur, a non-starter with us. We don't get that option. What we do have, is the option to balance and mediate the way we approach it. And that's what we're trying to do. Every step of the way is to mediate it, to try and let cooler heads, try and resolve this issue. My thought process, I understand this, and I'm certainly not an attorney, is that you're fixing to get a ruling from a judge here fairly quickly. When I say fairly quickly, prior to next summer. One of the major problems here, one of the major problems is the enactment of this in the July 4th weekend. Let's be honest for a second. That really exacerbated the situation. If you asked me if I thought the position about whether or not a prosecution could be made was going to change, I did not. I respect the state's attorney's position. I understand why they did it and what their interpretation of the rule of law is. I don't get to make those decisions. I'll be honest with you. The judge has to follow the rule of law from that standpoint, too. So just to be clear, nobody's been arrested in Walton County for trespassing against 2 miles ever. So if you take the position, some of the folks ask me, what about a court case? Should we not have a court case? And I think a couple of us were talking about, should we have a court case to see whether or not a judge would sign a warrant for trespassing? I think the problem with that, quite honestly, as I've said many times in front of interviews, I don't think that helps Walton County, because a judge is fixing to rule on this. So I'm not sure that's going to accomplish anything other than possibly hurting the county from that standpoint. But certainly, the worst thing that can happen in the law is for the public not to understand it, to be ambiguous. I do not like that. I am very, and I'll put this in my own hand, very displeased about that. But at the end of the day, I will execute your authority in a manner that makes sense, with a common sense approach, asking people to be reasonable where we can, and hopefully I can find some middle ground with this until a judge gives us an absolute decision. And that's where we're at. We need clear, unbiased answers. And until we get there, we continue to have issues. But I ask you to be patient with your deputies, because if somebody said this to me before, they do not have the options of not going out on a call. So let's be clear about that. So I don't care if you're for or against it. If you call a deputy sheriff, you're going to get one. But we're not in the business of going down there. We don't want to be there. It's hot in this polyester uniform. In case you didn't know that, it's not particularly comfortable for that standpoint. But we will try and always mediate. We're not in the business of dragging people off of each handcuffs. Now, you know, listen, if you lose your mind, you spit on a deputy sheriff, you punch him, do something, it's going to end poorly. So, yeah.